Salvation calls God, God. Everything that is called God was the cost of salvation. And that cost was packaged inside Jesus Christ, who we know as the Son of God, which more or less is God in the flesh. I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man can come to God except by me. There is no alternative. Yes, you're talking about the cost of salvation. What did it cost? I said it cost God in the previous part. It cost God himself because everything that made of God was inside Jesus. And it took the sacrifice of that Jesus on the cross to reconcile us back to God. To be saved actually means you have been lifted above sin, not just the consequence of sin. You have been lifted above sin. You have been empowered to live a life of dominating sin. Whatever the cause, the power, the consequence, and everything, he has lifted you up. Not because you are so powerful, but because he who sin could not ride, who rode over sin like a horse while he was here on earth as a man, lived in your place, and his life was accepted as a sacrifice for your own life, as an exchange for your own life. His life that he gave was a sacrifice that God needed to be able to to allow you to come back to him, to make it to be in one atonement with him. It reunites us back to God. The Bible makes us understand that the wages of sin is death. The consequence of sin is separation from God. And when man was separated from God, God did not make man to be separated. He made man actually for communion. If you go back to Romans, Genesis chapter 1, he made man for communion. But when sin came in Genesis 3, he separated man from God. And God said, I'm not going to have it. So God made provision because man couldn't save himself. It's like a prisoner who could, I mean, rather, somebody who has been maybe arrested by a policeman who is behind the counter. You can't bail yourself, no matter how great a person you are, no matter how much money you have. You need somebody who is free to come and bail you. So we needed somebody. And there was nobody. If you go to Revelation chapter 4, the Bible said, John said he wept profusely because there was no one that could open the seal or open the book or lose the seals thereof. That's in chapter 5 now. The book of redemption, until the Lamb that proceeded from the throne of God came and he prevailed. How did he prevail? He prevailed by beating law to the ground, by fulfilling all the laws of God as man. The only man that ever lived that did not sin, his name is Jesus Christ. There had never been any before him, neither has there been any after him. Because he fulfilled all of the will of God, that was like the Bible says, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. He fulfilled all of the laws of God, and because of that, the sacrifice of him on the cross became acceptable to God. God said, okay, if any man will believe in this man going forward that has fulfilled all that I wanted, because it was only one man also that missed it, that made us to be separated from God, because we were actually sinners by birth, not just when we started committing sins. And we were separated from God from the very beginning. So God now says, the same way that the sin of one man took us away from him, he accounted the death of Jesus as also good enough for every man who would believe in him to be able to reconcile back to him. And that's what we call salvation, when you are back to all the things that God has in mind for you, in good intentions of God for making man, can now be fulfilled in your life. Though you have been born a sinner, though you have sinned, but your sins have been forgiven and you have been empowered to now live a life that is pleasing unto God going forward. That's why we say somebody is saved. It's not just about your sins being forgiven. He empowers you also to live for him going forward. Thank you. See you next time.